And we are back here on IEMG Sports Weekly League Champions Edition. We're kicking it with the San Gorgonio girls soccer team, the back-to-back San Andreas League champions, undefeated back-to-back. I didn't mean to, you know, shortcut you guys. And Coach, how quickly did you guys get these shirts made up? I see the shirts already. It says undefeated 2015-2016 champs.
It says back-to-back on the back, too.
Does it really?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, we got those shirts. I didn't want to jinx ourselves, so they didn't come until after the season was actually over and we had wrapped it up. But yeah, they were in the works pretty much all season long. What are the shirts going to say? And just make sure we win and take care of business before we order the shirts.
Head coach Connie Beard here. And so obviously something that you guys are very proud of, right? Winning
Absolutely
the back-to-back
is.
San Andreas League titles. You did last year undefeated. Mm-hmm. Going into this year, was that kind of the goal from the onset? Let's go undefeated in league.
It really was. I had high expectations for this team this year. And from the beginning of the season was like, we're going to win league. We want to be undefeated and we want to go to playoffs. That was always the bigger picture. We're trying to win CIF this year. So I think a lot of times it's just let's make it to playoffs. You know, where do you fit in league? But this year was definitely let's win league, let's be undefeated, and let's try for that CIF title this year.
We also have Stephanie Topete here on the end of the couch. Hi, Stephanie.
Hi.
Let's talk about the season. What will you remember about this year? Why was this team that good? I mean, you guys won the San Andreas League title. You were undefeated. What did you guys do well this year to have that undefeated record?
Well, every practice we worked hard. Like, we wouldn't give up, and we would, like, encourage each other a lot. And we were just, like, family. And we were just, we just loved the sport.
We got Krista Pedroza, the goalkeeper, over here. Do you like being in the goal?
I do. I love it so much. It's like, I don't know, I wouldn't want to play any other position except for a goalkeeper. I love it.
You just like yelling at your defenders, right? Like,
yeah. Yeah, I do. I don't know, like, it just feels great, like, knowing that I'm going to stop them from scoring and I know my team is going to score goals and we're just working together all the time. It's great.
So you guys won the San Andreas League title. You won a playoff game, right? Made it to the second round. Unfortunately, the season ended in the second round. But, Coach, when you look at this season and what you guys were able to do, do you feel like it was a good season or do you feel like, man, I wish we could have went a little farther?
I think you always wish you could go further. I think that I was definitely disappointed. I know the team was disappointed because we had our sights set on CIF. That was the goal from day one. But looking back, I think that I was actually thinking about it this morning. Like, I have no regrets from this season. I think that we did the Saturday practices when we needed to do the Saturday practices. We worked hard. We went through all of the set plays that we needed to go through. I had everything this year for, like, the dream team. You know, I had good attitudes, good leadership. My seniors, my captains were good. I had a goalkeeper. I had the goal scorers. I had the midfield, the defense. I had everything this year for the making of a good team. It just wasn't our year. I mean, we played hard our last game against in CIF, and it was a 1-0 loss with 4 minutes left, or 2-1 loss with 4 minutes left in the game. It could have gone either way. So I think this year, to chalk it up, I'm happy. Like, it couldn't have gone better. Obviously, I wish for a different result, but I think it was a good season all around.
But Stephanie, that must be like a roller coaster ride. You know, it's probably, a week beforehand, you guys were winning the league championship, capping off an undefeated season. Everything's great, right? And then a week later, you guys lose in the second round. Yeah. But still, to make the playoffs, to win a playoff game, that's would be, you know, a great feeling, right?
Yeah. I was really happy the way we ended our season, winning league champs again.
So that was obviously important. Yeah. I mean, not only to win league, but to also go undefeated, right?
Yeah. Undefeated.
And Kristen had a big part in that because you got to stop the goals, right?
Yeah.
You
know, if
you
five shutouts in league.
Did you keep track of your stats? You know, like what your goals against might be.
I always counted. Well, not really, like, kept track, but I always made sure. Like, I especially because last year we went like basically 10 shutouts all last year. So this year I was like, no, like, I wanted to get 10 too, which it didn't happen, but I definitely, like, had my goal. Like, I don't want to get scored on this many times, and I made it happen. Like, I made sure it happened. Same with, like, preseason and all that. Like, I had my goal, like, set high this year.
All right, speaking of goalkeepers in the preseason, let's go back to the Sanji shootout, probably the biggest high school soccer tournament in the entire Inland Empire, maybe Southern California. You guys played a very good Redlands team that went to penalty kicks. And I'll start with you, Kristen, because you're in the cage. You're on your own little island, right? You're in the net trying to stop those shots. Kind of walk me through the process of going to a penalty kick shootout where it's just you and the other player. I mean, do you just focus on the ball? Do you not look at the other player in the eyes? I mean, what's the secret here?
I made no eye contact whatsoever. Like, I knew my parents were on the sidelines, everything, and I was like, no, like, I'm just, I stared at the ball the entire time. Like,
do you hear like coach yelling at you, or did you hear anything?
Some things, like, oh, like after I would block one of the balls or something, but other than that, I was like, no, like, I need to focus right now. I'm not even looking anywhere else. Like,
in a zone.
Yeah. Like, I just, it was like a different feeling. Like, there was, I knew there were so many people there watching us, but I was like, no, like, I need to focus. Like, I need to, we want to win, you know? So it was cool. That was a different feeling. Like, I've never felt like that before.
And coach, you said it was a real turning point, right? I mean, that's a good Redlands team from out of the Citrus Belt League. And what was it, 7-6 in PKs or something like that?
No, it was 6-5.
6-5?
6-5, but it went 11 shooters before that happened.
So the goalkeepers, like Kristen, were coming up big, right? So, I mean, what was that for the team maybe going forward and maybe confidence boost, I guess, of some sort?
Yeah, I think just having to go that long and, you know, the adrenaline rush at the end and the excitement of winning, you know, when it comes down to that, you know, because sometimes you'll score a goal and, you know, it's 2-1 and you have to wait until the whistle blows at the end to celebrate. And, you know, that last one that we made and the celebration of at the very end, I think that was a huge part for our team, a huge point for us that, you know, we had been struggling at the beginning of the season. We went to a really tough Norco tournament and saw some D2 teams that were really good there. And so I think playing in our own tournament, and we had good result the first day. We only had one loss, and it was a 2-1 loss to Alta Loma, who was in the CIF final for Division 5. And then to play Redlands and to tie them and take them to PKs was another big boost for us. So it was a good tournament, and that day, I think the excitement of going to PKs and winning in PKs was really the turning point for our team to get on the up.
Plus, you guys went undefeated in the league the previous year, but you just really never know what you have until you actually get your girls on the field, right? So even though you were great last year, didn't necessarily mean it was going to translate this year, but it did work out. You guys were great.
Yeah, it's true. You're right that no matter what you lose the year before, you know, everyone has to fill a different role and the chemistry's different. You add new players and leadership is gone, you know, from last year, some of my seniors that were leaders. And I think it takes, the team has to really mesh for everything to work out and to be successful, for everybody to get along. And I think we had that this year. I think that everyone got along. We're all close. Like, I actually liked the team, you know? I've liked most of my teams. I have to say I've been very blessed, but this year everyone got along and it just worked. You know, I had a good squad this year.
Well, Stephanie, Kristen, she really likes you.
I do.
You heard it here. Congratulations, girls, on the San Andreas League Championship. Back-to-back undefeated seasons.
Mm-hmm.
That's the San Gorgonio girls soccer team. We will be right back here on IEMG with Sports Weekly League Champions Edition. We'll be right back.